Exposure and three routes. So through inhalations, para para yung chemical, ingestion, pagsubo, absorption through skin, through open wound, and injection. So mga needle, na mayroong contain ng mga chemicals. Yeah. So ito yung example of chemical exposure symptoms. So eye, nose, throat, upper respiratory skin irritations, flu-like symptoms, difficult breathing, fatigue, loss of coordination, memory difficulties, sleepness, mental confusions. So ito ay nakapaloob sa MSDS. Kung ano yung mga health effects, nandun din yan. Kaya napaka-makikita nyo agad. Kung kayo gagawa ng report, pwede din nyo gawin yung reference. So ayan, kagaya na pagkat kanina, ito yung pag na-expose yung mga ating mga workers o yung ating mga manggagawa, there's a two types of exposure. Yung acute and chronic. Yung acute is immediate, direct exposure. So ito yung short term high concentration. For example, sa H2O exposed within confined space area. Yan. So yung chronic, may delayed reaction siya. Yan na really, nag-trigger siya ng years bago ma-detect. So continuous or long period of time na exposure dun sa hazard na yun, anumang chemical na yun. So yan. For example, asbestos. Yung asbestos po, hindi nyo siya makikita kasi airborne siya eh. Mai-inhale lang ninyo, lalo yan makikita sa mga lumang building. Nung ginawa namin yung ano, yung BSP, yung Baco Central of the Philippines, yung building na yun, ang ginamit doon ay asbestos. So, more chemical doon. So, marami yung kasakit doon dahil din, direnovate siya. Yun, ang daming mga na-affect doon sa area mo. So, basically, itong mga lumang building yan, asbestos type ang mga materials yan. Ayan, so, napaka-importante, i-discuss dito mamaya, kung ano yung mga preventions, mga control, pag kami mga ganong activity. Ayan. Ayan, so ito yun. Okay, so parte yan ng mga health effects, ha? Disorientation, peripheral light side, headiness, confusion, unconsciousness, headache, nausea, vomiting, paralyzed, so yun yung parts of the effects of the chemicals. Ayan. So ito naman yung biological. Some biological hazards that are contagious or can lead to death. Tuberculosis, AIDS, hepatitis, ABCE, chickenpox, URTI, sore throat, sexually transmitted disease. So lahat ko na ito alam, di ba? Skin disease. So yun yung mga biological hazards. Ayan. So ito yung department order na kung saan pinatibay ng section 1, this guideline shall apply to all workplaces engaged in the manufacturer, use storage, industrial chemicals in the private sector including supply chain. So yeah, nung ano siya, DO 13614 series 2014, yan. Yeah. Yung guidelines implementation of global harmonized system. Bibigay ko sa inyo yung copy nito para may reference kayo. So lahat siya nasa batas at pwede yung gamitin as a reference pag gagawa kayo ng report. Yan. So sa section 2, nakapalob dyan, these guidelines aims to protect workers and property from the hazards of the chemicals and to prevent or reduce the incidence of the chemically induced accident, illness, and injuries and death resulting in the use of chemical at work. So yan. Pwede yung gamitin yung reference. So ano ba yung duties ng employers at employees in the health safety committee? Yan. Yung employers, ulit-ulit lang yan, to ensure the deployment implementation and monitoring of the workplace policy program on the safety in the use of chemical which can disseminated to all concerned. So yan. Yan yung mga ano, to ensure the chemical are properly labeled, marked, that accurate safety data sheets are provided in accordance with the provision of GHA. So, napaka-importante lagi may GHA. Pag wala GHA, Global Harmonized System, huwag niyong i-allow, huwag niyong tanggapin sa inyong workplace. Okay? And six, ensure that the safety officer is in charge of the overall responsibility for the chemical safety in the establishment. He/she is working in This includes specific responsibility to perform regular inspection of the premises, labeling, storage, handling, and disposal of the chemicals. Nabanggit na natin kanina yan. And provide trainings, advice regarding chemical safety rules and procedure. So kayo, pag safety officer na, pwede kayong magturo ng chemical safety sa inyong work site o sa inyong pinagtatrabuhan. At pwede kayong bumuo ng chemical or emergency response team with regard sa chemical. Kasi meron mga ma-assessing sa oil and gas, manufacturing, kung saan meron din na ito sistema. Nabubuo kayo ng team or organization para doon. So employees shall comply with the policy and programs on the safe use of chemicals. Take all responsible steps to eliminate or minimize risk to themselves and to others from the use of chemicals. Yeah. Observe proper use of the safeguard and safety devices and report immediately to their supervisor any situation which they believe could be potential risk. Yeah. So, yung safety committee, gagawa sila ng dapat ng mag-develop ng accident prevention with regards to the chemicals or sa industrial area. Yan. At mag-direct sila ng accident efforts or the establishment in accordance with the safety program. So dapat nakapaloob itong programa to sa OSH program ninyo. Yan. And review the reports.